very first films that were ever made were eugenic propaganda movies. And if you're familiar with the eugenic movement, it started in I think the 1870s, and it officially ended in 1910, mm-hmm. but it still carried on. And what the eugenicists did, they targeted people that were stigmatized, and sterilized them. In some cases, the babies that were born with disabilities were basically left to die. And one of the movies that I want to talk about, that it disappeared through time, it's called Black Store. And it was directed by an actual doctor who endorsed the eugenic movement. And it was a fictionalized story on the actual case where he allowed a baby to die because he was born with cerebral palsy. And the movie showed what would happen if baby was allowed to live, and it showed the baby growing up to be like a monster. And that's interesting, because that same ideology or costume effect is still used today in modern horror films. Because Hollywood can't portray a monster without it being physically impaired or stigmatized in some way to indicate that this is evil. And basically what I'm about is just normalizing otherness, and because stigma is something that it can't be washed away.
Right.
You just can't wash it off easily. I'm about ending stigma.
Yeah. What are the barriers that you see to trying to represent? Do you find there's any barriers to representing better, like representing yourself or representing
better? I find with people in day-to-day social intercourse, it's hard because, with disability, for instance, we're the large minority in the world, but at the same time, we're the less, heard. We're the most disenfranchised. We're not able to have a voice on our own. So that's why, for me, I adopted a feminist philosophy to, help me find my voice. But we've nothing on our own to, spread our views or something like that. And, what I find in society, society in social ethical, you're pigeonholed. But initially by your old by physical characteristics and that enables people to interact. That shows people what way to interact with you. It's like, oh, this person looks like this, so I can interact with them in this way. Or it's like, with me, it's like, with people with disabilities, able to be binary between able-bodied people and people with disabilities is so vast. And I personally feel that able-bodied people tend to rely on stereotypes when engaging with people with disabilities. That's probably why for instance, like in shops, even though when I'm buying something, the shopkeeper would talk to the person with me, because what I feel is, what's your one disability? As far as able-bodied people are concerned, you could have anything. So,
they kind of infantilize you, do they?
Yeah. Patronizing is... That's one thing I absolutely can't stand. And like, it's kind of dehumanizing.
Yeah.
Well, as well, we're on the dating scene. It's kind of like a lot of people of different. I hate the word race because we're all human. We're all part of the human race at the end of the day. And but people of race, like different races, experiences as well.
Yeah.
Of fetishization. It's like I've never been with like a black person or something. So I really want to know what it feels like. It's like that's what I feel as well. People have actually said to me, I've always wanted to like have sex with someone in the wheelchair. See what it feels like. It's like, that is so objectifying. It's like, I'm a person, I'm not a bucket-list item. What else could I talk
about? I think that's good. You can talk for about 9 minutes. So that's perfect. You did great.